it was a wolf or something.
Gee, are all these little ones sick?
I'm afraid so, but Nurse Benson's marvellous with them. You like her, Doreen. Oh, Nurse Benson?
Yes, Doctor.
This is Mrs. Burns. She's interested in our nurse's aid programme. I'd like you to show her around the ward. Let her meet the children.
Oh, if it's no trouble, I'd be happy, sir.
And Mrs. Davidson and I have a few things to discuss. Take as much time as you want. We'll wait for you in my office.
All right, Doreen?
Oh, yeah. The kids will keep me company.
Is this your first time in a children's ward?
Oh, yeah, except when I have my tonsils out. Bit nervous, though, in case they don't like me.
I remember that feeling. Oh, they're terrific, and they'll be really excited to see a new face. You ready?
Yeah, here goes.
Children, we have a visitor.
Here comes the wolf. And he says, I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house down. And he huffs, and he puffs,
she seems,
and he
perfectly at ease with her friend.
All the way.
Even more important, they're perfectly at ease with her.
Oh, sorry.
We didn't want to interrupt. It was hard to tell who was having the most fun.
Oh, I reckon I was. They're really great. Simon can't laugh because he's just had his appendix out, but it's all right. We're playing with them, isn't it?
Oh, of course. You handle them very well. I'm most impressed.
Now, we really must be getting back, Doreen.
Oh, but I haven't finished the story yet.
Oh, I'm sure there'll be other times.
Oh, okay. Well, will you kids eat up all your tea and behave yourselves?
No.
And I'll see you real soon, won't I? Bye.
Bye.
And don't you worry, Dr. Henderson. If you give me a job here, I won't let you down.
I'm going to be waiting for you when you get out, Lizzie.
You bloody better be.
Of course I will. You're the best mate I've got.
Oh, look after yourself, love.
Don't be too long, Lizzie.
I won't.
I'm going to miss you, Bee.
Listen to me, little man. You come back in here, I'm going to clobber you.
Excuse me, lady, could you get out of my way? Not too close to the baby, you could give it germs.
Doreen!
You shouldn't be allowed anywhere near children, Burns. Reading a few Mothercraft books in prison and you think you know it all.
Oh, you're an eager beaver.
Is Elizabeth okay?
She had a good night.
Well, when's Chrissy getting her back?
Well, the doctor doesn't want her going back just yet in case she has a relapse.
But you said she was okay.
Oh, she can't be properly looked after in a prison. We're being careful, that's all. Yeah. Oh, by the way, I'm really sorry you're being moved. Some people have got narrow minds.
Yeah, thanks.
Well, cheer up. You'll be all right, as long as it doesn't happen again.
Just feeling a bit sick, that's all.
Oh, probably nerves starting on a new section.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Rotten mongrels. They don't want Chrissy to have you anymore. Gonna move you, just like they're doing to me. Except they're gonna shove you in a home. Well, I'm not gonna let them. Because I love you too much to let them hurt you. Are you looking for me?
Are you Doreen Burns?
Yeah, what's the trouble?
We just come from Wentworth General Hospital. We understand you disappeared this afternoon. You mind telling us where you've been?
Oh, of course not. I felt a bit crook, so I left work early. I've just been over to my neighbour's place to get an aspirin.
Do you know the Latham baby's disappeared?
Disappeared? Oh, gee, that's terrible. Do you know how it happened?
Yeah, well, we're asking questions of anyone who had a chance to take the baby without being noticed.
Well, I didn't see anything suspicious, because I would have told somebody right away if I thought anything funny was going on. I wonder if you could have a look at my baby, Doctor. I think she's pretty sick, girl.
Oh, well, they haven't been starving you, have they, Elizabeth?
It's a good girl. Yeah.
How long's she been like this?
About a day, I suppose.
I don't want to worry you, Mrs. Anderson, but I'm going to make an immediate appointment with a specialist for you down at the Wentworth Hospital.
But I can't afford a specialist. Couldn't you just give me a prescription? I can look after her.
Mrs. Anderson, you must take her to the hospital right away. She's a lot of fluid on her lungs and it might be serious.
Yes, Doctor. I'll get her there as soon as I can.
Doreen, I would like you to know that Elizabeth is off the danger list.
Oh, that's terrific. I'm glad. I'm real glad.
Oh, I bet you are, you bitch. If she'd have died, you'd be up for murder.
The fact that Doreen brought Elizabeth back when she did probably saved her life. Doreen, I would like you to tell Latham why you abducted her child.
I know why she took her. Because she'll never have any kids of her own, that's why.
No, Chrissy. I did it for Elizabeth. When I heard that they were going to put her in a home, well, I couldn't think of anything worse.
But they weren't taking her to a home.
I know, but that's what I thought they said. And you don't know what those places are like, but I do, and so does Chrissy, and I just wouldn't have that for Elizabeth. I was going to look after her until you got out. But then she got sick. She got real sick, and I knew I couldn't. But I couldn't just leave her. So I took her back to the hospital. You see, don't you? Oh, look, I know I was stupid, but I didn't mean to hurt her. I love that little kid, Chrissy. I suppose it is because I can't have any of my own. But I do love her.
You silly cow. Come here.
We've finished the tissue typing tests on all the women here who volunteered to have them done. Yours turned out to be compatible. This means, of course, that you will be eligible to donate one of your kidneys to B. Smith.
Well, everybody's real confident that you're going to be out of here in no time. I mean, there must be hundreds of people around with our sort of kidney. It's just a matter of finding them, that's all.
Why would they have to do that? And they've already found you.
Oh, well, in case I get crook or the doctors find out that they were wrong about me.
Or if you change your mind. That's what you're trying to say, isn't it?
Don't hate me, Bea. It's not because I don't love you. Because I do. You know that. Just I haven't got the guts to go through with it. It's too big, Bea, and I'm scared of it. I'm not real proud of myself either. And I know you said that we'd always be mates, but I can't see how we can be now. You must really hate me, Bea.
I just wish you'd said no right from the start.
Yeah, I know. That would have been better, I know that. But just everything happened so fast, I couldn't think straight. Please don't hate me, Bea.
Stupid. We are mates. Look, bugger off, huh?
When a prisoner is found with the outrageous sum of $95 on their person, I can only assume...
95, but...
Yes, Burns, you have something to say?
No, Mrs. Davidson, nothing you'd want to hear.
Very well. This money will be confiscated, and you will spend 2 days in solitary for your involvement. Thank you, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, Governor.
Hey, Burns, outside.
Yes, Miss Ferguson. I haven't worked it out yet, Miss Ferguson, but it's not much, because nobody seems too interested today. How come you didn't want me to leave it behind the fire extinguisher? Hey!
I'll have that, Burns, and the rest.
What do you mean, the rest? That's all there is.
Do you want me to search you?
No. Look, how do you expect me to run a book if I haven't got any cash?
Hand it over.
All right. Here it is. Well, you can stick your bloody book. I'm not taking bets for you anymore.
You're dead right. Because you won't be here.
Oh, no, not another transfer. Where are they shanghaiing me to this time?
You're not being shanghaied. You're being released.
What?
As from now, your sentence is over. You're going out those gates, hopefully never to be seen again.
What's with the bag?
Oh, I'm going, Jude. I got the job, you see, and I rang Mrs. Paxton and she said she wanted me to move in right away.
Oh, well, good, yeah.
It's not it really, Jude. And it's not you. Well, you've been really good to me, and you know that. It's just that I can't stand this lot any longer.
I understand, darling. You just come and visit me real soon, you hear? You promise?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye, love.
Hey, where's she going? Hey,
there you go.
Oh, see you, boy, that one.
Detective Sergeant Brent, Miss Phillips. Detective Constable Rawlings.
Hello.
We didn't have the opportunity of meeting our last visit.
Last visit? Doreen?
Oh, well, I was going to tell you. See, one of my mates, B. Smith, well, she's escaped from Wentworth and, well, she had a postcard from me with our address on it.
Oh, she what? How on earth could you be so stupid?
Well, she's my mate.
And, Sergeant, you think this woman might show up here?
We think it's a possibility.
Oh, but that's absurd.
That's what I've been trying to tell him too. Bee's real smart, you know. She would have figured out that the police would be sniffing around me, so she's probably hundreds of miles away.
That's not very likely, Miss Burns. We have positive identification. Smith is here, in Sydney.
Oh, gee.
Well, she's not in my flat, Sergeant, and I can assure you she won't be.
Look, all we're asking from Miss Burns is that she contact us if Smith ever gets in touch with her.
But...
it's for Smith's own good. The longer she stays on the run, the more chance there is of someone being hurt.
Don't worry, Sergeant. If Smith shows up, I shall personally call you.
Excuse me, madam. Can I help you?
Oh, I don't know. What do you reckon?
B. Lucky B. Don't look now. That woman over there, she's an undercover cop.
All right, Doreen, calm down.
But you've got to get out of here.
Leave now. It'll just look worse. She'll follow me. Yeah, well, I haven't decided what I want yet. I thought I might just pick a few out and try them on, if that's all right.
Ah, well, see if there's anything you like, and I'll be with you in a moment.
Thanks.
Why don't you look after these ladies here, and I'll look after that one. Well, you are here to work, aren't you?
Yes.
Sorry, B. I took so long because I got tied up with a customer.
Oh, that's all right.
Oh, geez, I was worried about you, you know, breaking out and all that.
No need to worry about me.
Well, it's good to see you, though. You are okay, aren't you?
Yeah, fit as a fiddle. Looking pretty dangerous yourself.
Well, I knew that you'd come to me sooner or later, but what took you so long?
I knew they'd be watching you. I didn't want to get you into any strife.
Well, you can stay with me as long as you like. You know that. And we'll find a way to fool those cops.
No, thanks, love, but no thanks. It's too risky.
Yeah, but I got this...
Forget it. We'll never get away with it. Besides, you're not going back inside for me.
I've got to do something to help. How you offer money?
As a matter of fact, I'm pretty skint. I had a fair bit of cash that won't get into Sydney. I've got a couple hundred bucks from the old bag I was working for. That'll be gone soon. Food is so bloody expensive.
Is it ever? Well, how much do you need?
I hate to ask you for it, but just enough for me to, you know, keep going and start off somewhere new.
Well, I'll go and see how much I've got in my bag. Look, try these on in case that sneaky Megan's hanging around.
Okay.
Oh, you could have made me a cup of tea, B. I've had a bugger of a day.
How you going, you old tart?
Oh, terrific. Gee, it's good to see you.
Yeah. I wish you could have seen your face in that shop.
Well, what do you expect? It's not every day you come face to face with a double murderess.
Which reminds me, is your watchdog still outside?
I wouldn't be a bit surprised. Yep, there he is, the poor man's pink panther. G'day, Spunky! I love doing that. Every time I wave to him, he ducks behind a car and makes out he doesn't even know who I am.
Same old Doreen. Well, looks like I have to stay here the night. You're not expecting anyone, are you?
No, my flatmate's away for a couple of days, so you can hang around here until she gets back if you like.
Thanks, love, but no thanks. I think I better keep heading north. Might as well keep going while my luck holds.
Oh, yeah, but you've done all right so far. But how did you do it? Did you really just walk out of Wentworth like they said you did on the telly?
Yeah. I can hardly believe it myself. Look, I'm starving. I'll tell you about it when we get tea.
No, look, I'll get it. I've learned to cook, you know. You just sit there and relax.
195 a week. He must be joking.
Yeah, but that covers everything. Well, it doesn't, really. It doesn't cover me fares or if I go out, but almost everything else.
Well, that sort of money I'd want to. God, I'd want hot and cold running blokes. How much do you earn at the shop?
Not enough. That's the problem. My bank account's taken a real hard knock.
Well, then why the hell live here? Why not?
I've got to be. I know it sounds crazy, but Barbara Fields once said something to me, and I reckon it makes a lot of sense. She said if you really want to make a go of it in this world, you've got to put up a bit of a front.
What?
Well, you know what it's like. If you look as though you've got a bit of money, people treat you a bit decent. I mean, look at me in that halfway house. They treated me like I was a charity case. I mean, they meant well enough, but, well, you could practically see their halos light up every time they smiled or gave you a dollar.
What about your flatmate, what's her name, Debbie?
She's all right. She's a bit tight with her money, that's all. She wants me to pay a bit more for food than her because she reckons I eat more. But that doesn't go for all her freeloading friends that come over here.
Look, I know it's not my life, but why don't you move out of here to the other side of the harbour? Here you're only paying for the view. I know I shouldn't talk after all the money I've taken.
Oh, shut up, Bea. That's different. You're my mate, remember? You don't really have to go tomorrow, do you, Bea?
Yes, love, I do.
You could stay on another day.
No, Doreen, I don't want to push my luck. Besides, you've done enough for me already.
Yeah, but that's because we're mates.
And that's another reason. You've done really well for yourself, and I'm proud of you. If anything happened to you because of me, I'd never forgive myself.
What the hell's that? Who is it? Debbie.
I'm sorry, Doreen. I know I should have called. I just didn't get a chance. Everything happened so quickly. Anyway, I didn't check the mailbox. I'll do it now. You can introduce your friend to me.
Hold it!
I'm warning you, you try and leave here, your flatmate is going to have throat trouble.
Please, Debbie.
What do you want?
Doreen here is not being very cooperative. So much for old mates. So it's up to you.
Go on.
But for starters, you can go and see if the cops are still out front. Don't be stupid. From the window.
Police?
He's in an unmarked car, silver, registration number KDH540.
Yes, he's looking up.
We'll wave to him. Now come here and get that clothesline from the bathroom.
What do you want?
Get! If you're not back here in 2 seconds, your flatmate is going to be mince meat. You better have this back. If I'm caught with it, I mean, they'll know you gave it to me.
Okay. Hell, I'm gonna miss you, Bea.
Just keep going straight. I'm real proud of you. Thanks for everything. Toss it over here. Now get over here and lie face down on the floor. Here, tie her up.
Oh, come off it.
Do it! Okay, you two, just keep looking at the floor. This is where I say goodbye.
I need you to come down to the station and give us a statement sometime.
But not today.
No, tomorrow will be fine. Well, thanks for your help, ladies. I'll see myself out.
Okay. Oh, thank God that's over with. Doreen?
Yeah? Oh, yeah, terrific.
Do me a favour. Next time you have friends around, make sure they're not on the run, will you?
There won't be next time, Debbie. I'm moving out.
Moving? Why?
Just can't afford to stay on this side of the harbour anymore.
Oh, well, thanks very much. How am I supposed to afford this on my own?
Oh, you'll be all right. You'll find someone else. I'm sorry, Deb, but I am going. I've been talking to a friend and she said that I'd be mad for staying here.
Oh, I see. She's talked you into moving in with her, has she?
No. No, she didn't, as a matter of fact. But I wouldn't mind. She was the best friend I ever had. Oh, you got such a big stretch this time, Helen.
Oh, well, the company's good.
Yeah, I miss it a bit too. Especially when I need somebody to talk to, like me old mates.
Oh, there's not many of them around now, love.
No, I know. Hey, what's all this about Jude being out? Is she on a work release or something?
No, she's in a singing competition.
A singing competition? Well, how come you're not there?
Oh, because of my snake bite. There's a whole group of them in it. It's a wonder they're not back by now, though. Must be doing all right.
Yeah. Didn't do nothing like that when I was in here. We had some real good times, though, didn't we?
Now, what's the matter, Doreen? If you're feeling sentimental about this dump, things can't be too good on the outside.
Yeah. Well, I have got a bit of a problem.
Well, can I help?
I don't think anyone can. You see, I'm going to get married.
That's good news, isn't it? So why marry him, for Christ's sake?
I'm sort of stuck with it.
Are you up the duff or something?
Oh, no, nothing like that. He's nice, but he doesn't turn me on. We're just mates, that's all.
Well, then why the wedding bells?
Well, he's got a couple of months left on his visa and he wants to live here.
So he marries an Aussie girl and he's home and hosed.
Right.
Well, then what's the problem? You live together, you separate, and then 12 months you get a divorce.
The silly bugger's gone and fallen in love with me. I mean, he wants to make it for real. I mean, I think he's nice, but that doesn't mean I want to spend the rest of my life with him. It's not funny, Helen.
Well, then just tell him to forget it.
Well, I can't. Because he's too nice. Well, he helped me in art classes and everything. You can't kick a mate in the teeth, can you?
Well, then just disappear until he leaves the country. Then you can be pen pals.
Well, that's what I'm trying to do. I even came to Melbourne to try and shake him, but he sticks to you like B.O. What am I going to do?
God, I don't know. Seems to me the only place you'd be safe would be in the nick. Haven't got fellas chasing me.
Yeah.
Oh, God, it's a hard life, Mr. Manning, when you're irresistible.
Thanks for the escort, love.
Hey. Oh, sorry, any time, love.
Oh, well, I might have a free night tonight.
So Mrs. Reynolds just heard... What are you doing here?
God, I'd forgotten about you. It's funny how you only remember the good things, eh?
Well, no doubt you'll be back here soon. So you can refresh your memory.
You never know. You might be right, Miss Ferguson. You just keep that welcome mat out for me, won't you? When I checked out of the motel, I was having breakfast too. And that's when I figured that your idea was the best one, Helen.
My idea?
Yeah, about coming back to Wentworth.
Oh, you'd have to be off your tiny mind. Nobody with half a brain wants to get back in this dump.
No, I know what I'm doing, Helen. See, just 5 or 6 weeks in this place, and when I get out, he'll be gone.
Now, look, he cannot be as bad as getting back in the nick. Why don't you just marry him? Love's more comfortable the second time around.
Oh, Helen. No, come on. Just give me a few hints just to get back in here for a few weeks.
You're on your own, Doreen. I'm not contributing to the delinquency of a raving nut.
Gee, and I thought you were me mate, too.
One time's up, Doreen.
Oh, it's all right, Mrs. M. We're going to have lots of time to catch up on everything soon. Look, the money's not important. You just tell me how much you can afford.
Young lady, I'm a churchgoer.
Oh, at this time of the afternoon.
Disgusting. Outside a police station, too.
Oh, I like church. Hello, gorgeous. How would you like the night of your life? Won't cost you the earth, either.
Where are we going? The movies?
Oh, come
Come on, lover. I know some really sexy love games.
I'm a backgammon man myself. See this, sweetheart? It's not my Mickey Mouse Club badge.
Oh, no, you're a cop.
Right. Nobody minds you earning a living, but not outside our front door, huh?
Aren't you going to arrest me?
Soliciting's not a crime.
Bugger it. What are you doing this for?
We're protesting against the filth that man is selling in that shop.
It has to be stopped. Pornography degrades women and children.
Yeah? Kids too. Mm. Gee, that's disgusting. Oh, we know our rights. Hey, copper, this is a public place, so piss off. Down with police. Down with dirty pictures. Down.
Look, love, I don't want to get heavy with you, okay? So go home and cook hubby's dinner like a good girl.
Oh, wouldn't you know? He's going to be a male chauvinist as well. Well, down with male chauvinist pigs. Down with dirty
coppers. That's it. You're coming with me.
Oh, yeah, you're going to charge me, are you?
You bet your boots.
Yeah, well, I'm going to do something to make sure you do. Yeah, well, come on.
Come
what
on.
Are you waiting for?
That's enough.
Hey, sir, you haven't been
Doreen. Oh, no. Yeah, got your new playmate, or should I say an old one? Some people are like bad pennies, aren't they? Always turning up.
Yes, okay. See, she hasn't changed, has she?
And neither of you, you silly little bugger. I told you not to do it.
Did you really wangle a holiday in here?
Yeah, why not?
You're crazy. You're absolutely crazy.
What are you looking so pleased with yourself about?
Geez, Helen, I never thought it'd be so hard to get extra time. I never had this trouble last time I was in here.
You're priceless, Doreen. Why don't you try and escape? Now, that's sure to drop a clangor in here the way things are going.
I'm trying to stay in, Helen, not get out. And with my luck, I'd probably get away with it.
So why don't you do what you said you were going to do? Drop your gear and streak?
Yeah, give the freak a thrill. But will you all shut up? I've got a thing.
You better get a move on, Burns. That was the end of work bell.
Yeah.
Something the matter?
Oh, no.
Good. You better get going, eh?
Yeah. Oh, no. Look what's happened now. Must have a dicky wheel.
Well, well, well.
Oh. Reckon you've caught me fair and square this time, Mr. Manning. I'll have to front the VJ now, eh?
Well, you can be sure of one thing, Burns. I'll be talking to someone about it. I'll get back to you. Look, you better go. You're going to miss your exercise period.
Yes, Mr. Manning?
Yeah, little Dickie Bird whispered to me that you're trying to extend your sentence on purpose. Is that right?
Oh, I wouldn't do anything like that. That'd be real stupid, wouldn't it?
Bloody stupid, Benzie. Too stupid for me to have anything to do with. All right?
Right, Mr. Manning. Bugger it.
What happened?
Nothing. What's the world coming to when you can't even get a screw to dob you?
You know, Burns, I have heard that you got yourself put back in here on purpose this time and you're angling for an extra couple of weeks. I'll try any of your tricks on me and your stay here will be permanent. Where have you been?
The loo.
Is there anyone left in the kitchen?
Yeah, I'm going back now.
Well, move it.
You know, you've got a real way about you, Miss Ferguson. I don't know how this place would run without you. I know a few people who'd like to find out, though. You mean you don't want to marry me anymore?
I know this is a shock, but my family, they are, how you say, very old-fashioned. It would kill Muti, my mother, if she finds out my wife is in the prison. You understand?
Oh, yeah, of course. But what about your visa? Will you have to go back?
Oh, no, this is what is so wonderful. One door slams, another one opens. Nine. I meet this charming woman, Felicity. She, a little older, but very sophisticated. She is, what is her? patroness of the arts.
Oh, yeah, a patroness.
Yeah, we thought straight away. And now we will marry, and she will sponsor my painting. Is this not good news?
Oh, bloody terrific. But you see, I could still get you for breach of promise.
Breach of... No, Doreen, you do not wish me to make a mistake. If you do not wish to marry with me, I would not force you. We are both free people, yeah? Well, nine, be kind. Do not cry. You will meet somebody else.
No physical contact, please.
Mrs. Morris, I did not wish to upset her.
Oh, no, I'm sure Doreen understands that. But I'm afraid to tell you, you've run out of time.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Oh, bloody hell, I've just remembered. I just copped 2 extra weeks, and now the bugger's dumped me.
Doreen.
Oh, Doreen, please do not be cross. We are still friends. I send you pictures of the wedding, yeah?
Yeah, well, I reckon it's a real hoop. All this time you were worried about knocking him back and he was off with someone else.
It's not bloody funny. Oh, well, crikey, Mrs. M. Millie cracked up too. There's Han standing there saying he's going to send me the wedding pictures. Bloody nerve.
Oh, hang about. You could always use them for dartboard practice.
Yeah, well, I'll have to do something for the next 2 weeks.
It's Burns, Governor.
Oh, good. Bring him in.
Oh, hi. I just wanted to say how sorry I am about everything.
Not as sorry as we were to see you back in here, Doreen.
Oh, yeah.
But now that you're getting out, I just want to wish you all the best and hope we don't see you again.
No, Mrs. Reynolds. What? You mean I am getting out today?
Of course. Haven't you been counting the days?
Oh, yeah, but...
Don't tell me you've been beaten at your own game, Doreen.
Oh, you rotten bugger.
All right, Mr. Manning, you can take her along now, unless you want to put her on a charge for abusing an officer.
No, I'll let it go this time.
Oh, thanks. Can I say goodbye to my friends? I didn't get a chance to say...
All right, Doreen, but no next times, please, or we mightn't be so lenient.
Yeah, don't you worry, Mrs. R. Much and all, as I think you've got some pretty spunky fellas around here. I reckon there's a lot more on the outside. Come on, Mr. Manning, in case you change your mind, go that charge. God, I wonder what's keeping her. You know, Mrs. M's spending too much time with Pixie. I reckon she's as scatterbrained as a sheep at the abattoirs.
I wouldn't let Mrs. Morris hear you say that, Burns. You're not out of here yet.
Oh. And Mrs. Barfield heard this one? Home presents a dismal picture, dark and silent as the tomb. Father has a navel stricture, mother has a fallen womb.
Yet we face the future fearless, although fortune rarely smiles. Mind your job is cold and cheerless, chip and ice for grandpa's pies. But this family knows its duty. We will not be put about, though Aunt Mary blew a beauty.
Turned her stockings inside out.
Leave the intercom.
I suppose you think that's very funny, Doreen, but it's little tricks like that that'll land you right back in here again.
Oh, good on you, Dor.
Oh, God, well, I heard her make it an entrance, but that takes the cake for an exit, huh?
Oh, Judy, isn't she cheeky? It's a naval stricture.
And I've a good mind to take you straight back to
Mrs. Morris. What is it?
That was Mrs. Reynolds. She said, would you please escort Doreen to the front gate as soon as possible?
Gladly. Sign that.
Now, can I just say goodbye to...
No, Doreen. Now, out.
Bye, Mrs. Barfield.